Hi, Phyllis here from southernfrugal.com. I want to show you how this Omega, it's an Omega 8005 juicer goes together. Now, to me, having had the other kind of juicer, these really are much easier to clean, in my opinion. And supposedly the juice is much healthier for you when the juice is squeezed out rather than using the, let me think what they call the centrifugal thing that turns around and spins around. These are supposed to be healthier. I don't know if they are or not, but anyway, that's what they say. But the cleaning up this juicer, to me, is just a whole bunch easier. The only part that you really have to like use a little brush on, and you don't really have to use it that much, is this little part right here. You have to kind of put that brush in there, kind of use the brush out there, but that's really the only part. The rest of it really just rinses off. So what I did was just put it down in a little soapy hot water and then rinsed it off and used a little brush on this part, and voila, you're all done. All of this just cleans off really, really easy. All right, so I want to show you how I put it together. All right, so the first thing you do is put this section on. It's still wet where I washed it earlier. And it really just snaps right in there. You just kind of have it like that. And then you just push it over to close, and it closes right. Can you see that? You just push it over to close, and it closes right up. Then the next thing you do, and this is very heavy, this is the thing that actually mashes everything up. And you just put that in, goes in a little, snaps right in. And then the next thing you put on, if you are doing juicing, now there's another one that's just like this, only it doesn't have the little screen that you use for making pasta. And I don't know, I guess grinding meat too. Anyway, I haven't done that yet. So this just goes right in there, snaps sort of in place. That's all there is to it. Then you just put the little top on it. Twist it to close, and there you have it. And so this is the little part that you put on top. Now the only drawback to it that I can see is you can't, it's slow. You can't do, you know, much at one time. So there's what it looks like. Let me move in closer. There's what it looks like sideways. Right there. Can you see that? Yeah, it's pretty easy. And they actually say that you can put it in the top rack of the dishwasher. I haven't done that yet because this is only, well, this will be the third time I've used it. But anyway, today I'm going to do some vegetables, because I got pretty excited about the other juice. It tasted really good, except next time I decide I'm not going to put celery like in a, you know, fruit juice type thing. But this we're going to do as a vegetable juice, and hopefully it will be good. And then it just comes with the little baskets, and this one's got a little strainer on it, which will strain out, you know, some of the pulp and also some of the foam. So you put that under there, and the juice, can y'all see that? Let me turn it up. The juice comes out right there. So that one goes in first, and then this one catches the pulp at the far end. So we're going to go ahead and do this and try some different stuff and see how it works. So I've got, I wanted to try a little bit of, this is just a little bit of fennel stalk. And celery, let me just go down and see if you can see. Celery, which I had, and I'm going to use some tomatoes. I bought a whole big bushel of these tomatoes, and they do taste very much vine ripened. I'm going to use some flat leaf parsley, just because it's real high in potassium. And I'm going to go ahead and use more carrots. These are those little baby carrots. And of course, did I mention I'm going to go ahead and put celery in this one? Now, so far, the thing that did the best was the celery. It really just chewed it right up. And I'm going to go ahead and cut up a little head of the red cabbage, because I also, last fall, bought a bushel of this, and I had to peel off some outer leaves because they were kind of deteriorating, but I'm going to try using the red cabbage too, because this is super, super healthy for you. But in order to get the full benefit, when you juice, I know on the red cabbage you need to, you know, drink that juice right away. And I'm also going to put in some kale. Now, the instructions, let me talk to you a minute. The instructions say that you can put in greens. This will actually do greens. So I haven't tried any yet, but we're going to try them today and see if it really works. All right, so we're ready to go with it. All right, so I'm going to have to do some cutting up of stuff here, but I can also get it going. Maybe I'll start out with the celery. Plug this little baby up. Make sure everything is locked in place, and it gives you arrows on here showing you how it's locked in place. All right, we're ready. Here we go. Let's start out with some celery. We'll turn it up so you can see. We'll go a little closer. There we go. Here's some of the carrots. Now some of these carrots, you have to push them down pretty hard. And if anything gets stuck, you can just put it on reverse. Out is really fairly dry. Alright, I think I'm going to try tomato next. Now I have to cut that up. Let's see how it works. Right up. All right, let's do just a couple more carrots. Yeah, I think the longer carrots work better. All right, I'm going to try the parsley now. This is a flat leaf parsley or Italian parsley. Hopefully it will work. Just going to pan that in there. Push it down with some celery. It does greens. Who knew, right? All right, I'm going to do the little fennel. Did that great. Might as well go ahead and put some kale in it too while we're at it. I'll use the celery to push it in. Yeah. It's working. It's definitely doing the kale. And it certainly did the parsley. Of course, we don't know what this is going to taste like, but... All right, I got about four more little carrots here. Let's see if I can get rid of those. Okay, I'm becoming very impressed with this. It's a little more... parsley, and we'll put some more kale in there. Well, to my great surprise, let me see if you can see that up there, the greens work extremely well. I wouldn't have thought that. I would have thought they would get stuck in there, but they don't. Let's see if I can get some more of this red cabbage in there. It's kind of like kind of cut it up a little bit. Like that. It's very crispy, so I think that's helping. I don't know what this is going to taste like, but hopefully it'll taste good. Let's do the rest of the kale, since I've got it left here. I'm becoming very impressed with this juicer. Now look at that. Can y'all see that? It's taking those greens. All right, I'm going to do one more tomato. Definitely takes longer to do this than it does to do the Vitamix, for sure. This makes quick work of these tomatoes. Use my celery again to push it down. Alright, so I'm going to have to get a spoon because the little thing that catches some of the pulp is almost at the top. And they do that, they do this little screen in order to catch the foam and any little bit of pulp that's left. But I'm thinking I might want to drink the pulp too. There's a little bit in there. All right. got the two stalks of celery left, so let's put those in. So now to take this apart, well, let me take my juice out first. Now there's the juice, and I'm gonna let this drain a little bit more here. Actually, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm just gonna dump that in because I would like to really have a little bit of the pulp. Turn this down so you can see. Yeah. I'm just going to take this off and dump it right in. So there's some of the pulp it caught. Seems to me that would be good, but we'll just leave it for now. All right. I'll pour it into this jar now. All right. Let me see. This jar is... Let's see, I think it says 40 ounces. All right, there it is. Let me back off here. I'm gonna give this a try. Pour some out in a glass. See what it tastes like. Oh, it's good. It tastes like V8. Doesn't look like V8, but that's what it tastes like. Hmm. And it sure doesn't need any salt or anything. It's really good. Hmm. Very good. Hmm. I can taste the tomato and the celery, and I think the red cabbage gives it a little bit of a, you know? All right, I'm going to pour some for Mr. Bucky and he's home from his prayer breakfast, and I'm going to see what he thinks it tastes like. I'll be back. All right, I decided to just bring the camera in here and let Mr. Bucky tell you what he thinks of this juice. He's certainly drinking it fast. Well, all right, what did you think?
This is very refreshing. And I'll tell you what, it really helps me to digest what I had this morning for the men's prayer breakfast.
Why don't you tell them what you had
for
breakfast?
Well, we had a good old Southern breakfast. You know what I'm saying? We had bacon and sausage and scrambled eggs and grits and, of course, some good sausage gravy.
Is that delicious. Milk gravy
right,
stuff?
Right, yeah. It's just delicious. You know how good it is.
Did you say biscuits? You had biscuits?
And biscuits.
Who made those biscuits?
Well, I think one of the wives made those.
Made the biscuits?
Yeah, I think Tammy made them.
Yeah.
And they were excellent. And of course, though, no amount of juice, and I had some apple juice and coffee, of course, could wash down the...
Cholesterol, is that the word you're looking for?
But you gave me this, and you know how much I love V8 anyway.
Yeah, does it? You think it tastes like V8?
It does. It really does. It tastes like V8, and it's better because I'm sure it's better because it doesn't have any preservatives in it, and that's what.
Plus, it's raw.
Oh yeah,
that order.
Knowing what V8 can do for your body, and I've already talked to you about that. How. If you drink enough V8, you can wipe out any cold, you know that,
yeah.
Or any kind
have
of
you
infection.
Got your, have you got your sweatshirt on backwards?
Yes, I do.
Why do you do that?
Well, I didn't want that. And when I came in, it had gotten colder.
Uh-huh.
And so I put it on backwards. I didn't think you would come in and film me.
Well, hey, if the world's going to know, you wear your sweatshirts turned inside out.
Sometimes I do, because sometimes I don't like that frilly stuff on my body.
Is it itchy?
Yeah, a little bit itchy. But I've gotten warm now, so I was about to shed this sweatshirt.
All right. Let's get back to the juice. Mm-hmm. So your opinion, do you think it tastes... First of all, it almost looks black. Turn it around so they can see what it looks like. It almost looks black.
It's a little darker than the V8.
Oh, a lot darker. It almost looks black.
I think you said something about the red cabbage.
I did. I put the red cabbage. Because the red cabbage, they're actually studying that red cabbage now to do with its ability to fight cancer. So probably some drug company's going to figure out something that they can derive from the red cabbage.
Now, that doesn't need a bit of salt.
That's what I thought, too. Yeah. It didn't need salt at all.
And sometimes I use a little Worcestershire, but it doesn't need
Worcestershire either. Yeah, I know, and we try to discourage that because it's so salty. But I agree. It doesn't need a bit of salt. It's great tasting.
It's really good. You did this with your juicer?
Yeah, I did it with your juicer.
My juicer, okay.
Yeah. That's the one you insisted on,
yeah,
remember?
Yeah, well, that's right. That's right. You needed one. But this is really good, babe.
Okay, well, I got a little more in there now. I thought it was really good, too. So, okay, well, several people have been asking me for stories to get you to tell some more stories. Can you think of any real quick?
Oh, no.
No?
I'm not right this second. I can't think of any.
All right, y'all see how hard it is for me to get him to tell some of his stories on camera?
I'll tell some stories a little bit later, maybe. But this, I declare... I'm glad you brought me this juice.
Yeah, I did. The main reason is to try to flush out all that cholesterol you ate about, 3 hours
That's
ago, right.
Right? That's right. But you know what? I've been wondering how it was going to taste with the V8. And,
mean to taste like the V8?
Well, I was going to wonder. I wondered,
comparing it.
I was going to compare it, yeah.
So I really think it's better, Bucky, really.
It is. And... to think that you don't have to add any salt, you don't have to add any Worcestershire.
Yeah. And, you're famous for adding Worcestershire to... also added the teriyaki to V8. I've seen you do that. That's a bad habit to be into. It really
well,
is.
Well, don't need to do it on this.
Well, I really super like that, too. Now, remember, I saved you a little bit of that carrot and sweet potato, apple, orange. I think it had grapes in it. I actually like this better than the fruit juice. Mm-hmm. Did you? You got a little bit of that earlier.
Yeah, I got some fruit juice earlier. Well, you had some celery in that one, didn't you?
Yeah, that's what it was.
There's a little bit of a taste of celery in there, which, of course, I don't like the celery quite as much.
But now this one's got celery in it. It's got four stalks in it.
Well, you've overridden it with the tomato juice, though.
Yeah, I guess
so. I mean, that's taking it, that's really neutralized. Any taste that you might have gotten from the celery. What all you got in this?
But, all right, that's got red cabbage, carrots, celery, parsley, kale, some of that curly kale, and of course, the tomato. Okay. I didn't really put as many, I had a whole bunch of tomatoes in there. I was thinking I was going to use a lot, but I ended up not doing that. Remember when we were looking at all these different juicers, and remember I told you I wanted one that would do greens.
Yeah.
Okay, it does the greens better than it does the little carrots.
It does.
Yeah, it really did.
Okay.
All right.
Well, I think these are Marion tomatoes.
Oh, are they?
They taste,
definitely taste vine ripened to me.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I got a whole bunch more out in the garage. Okay. So I'm thinking, Mr. Bucky, that we might want to have this maybe once a day. I mean, I liked it that well. Did you?
Well, yeah, I like it. You know how I like V8 anyway.
Yeah, that's true.
And so I could, just in the past, I'd just drink it by the quart.
Yeah, you do, yeah.
Sometimes
in fact, we used to buy it. Four big bottles at one time at Walmart, remember?
Well, especially
with
coupons.
Remember? We used to get coupons on that.
When I was up in McCormick, when I was a headmaster up there at the private school, sometimes I would, as you do in schools, you pick up an infection from the kids, or one kid gets a cold and everybody does.
Yeah.
And so I would come down with something and I'd go home. I might drink a whole bottle of V8.
At one time?
Well, I might. And but I'd wake up gone. The infection gone. Best anti-cold in the
world.
Well,
so this is like an advertisement for V8.
That's right.
But now we're going to do the all-natural.
No preservatives.
And it's raw. It's not cooked. So you've got all those enzymes in there. Okay, well, you've sold me on the juicer. Okay. All right, so I better cut this short so it's not so long. Okay. All right, so you're going to get back to you. He's working on his website. And there are the dogs. Two of them asleep. I think the other one's over there in the bed. This is how we live right here.
That's right.
And with him with his sweatshirt on, turned wrong side out. All right. So I'm going to go back in there and I'm going to show them how I clean that thing, because it's really easy to clean that juicer. You really sold me on it, Mr. Bucky.
You know
how I was in doubt from it from almost the beginning, but now with the vegetable juice, now I definitely like the vegetable juice better than that with the sweet potato and the fruit this morning.
And I've got some more stories. I'll just have to get them organized sometime or another. We'll tell them.
Yeah, I know you got about 1,000 stories. All right, so we're going to go back in the kitchen now.
Okay.
All right, we are back in the kitchen. We drank it all. It's really that good. And I just wanted to show you about the cleaning up. Now, first of all, I didn't use nearly as many tomatoes as I thought I would. I'm not sure why, but I used what that looks like about a third of the head of red cabbage. Now the cabbage gave it a little kick, like you put a couple of drops of hot sauce in it, but it was very, very good. All right, so we will definitely be having this again probably sometime tomorrow. And I was very surprised at how well the greens did in here. I would have never guessed that, even though when we were looking at them, one of my requirements was that it would do the greens. And even though it said it would do the greens, I was very skeptical. But as y'all saw this morning, it definitely did the greens. Now, I just have a problem throwing all that away, but I really don't know what else to do with it because it's so mixed up in there. Smells good though, okay? But I guess it's going to go in the compost bin. But anyway, I wanted to show y'all how to take this apart. It is so easy to clean. In fact, I'm going to move my little pan up here, my little container, and show you how easy it is. And I've actually got my camera sitting in the sink. All right, so all I do is just get some, fairly hot water in one of these little plastic containers that I use all the time. And put a little soap in it. All right, I want to see if I can show y'all how to take this apart. It's really easy to do. Y'all see that? Take this top thing off, put that down in the water. Then you just take this off, it just turns right off. That comes out, and I'm gonna rinse these off. Then you just pull this out, like that. Actually, this thing comes out, like that. Just put that down in the sink, I'm gonna rinse it. You just open this up, and it comes right off. And then see, this stays all clean, so you don't have to do anything to this part. All right, let me see if I can fix it so y'all can see. I don't know how to do that. All right, so all I do, I could turn all this around. Okay, hold on a minute. All right, this is how simple cleanup is. I'm just going to rinse my little cutting board off. This is the thing that actually grinds everything up, and it just rinses right off, like that. You can put it in the dishwasher. This is the top part of it, and just rinse it off. All it takes. And this is the little strainer that will strain out the any pulp. Now, I'm thinking the next one I make, I'm going to move some of this pulp in and, you know, maybe not use the strainer. I hope this video isn't getting too long. It seems like it's going to be long. A little thing that hooks everything on. Take that right off. And the old part you really have to clean. Or, well, I mean, we're going to wash it all in soapy water, including these little containers. Of course, this will go out to the compost bucket. But here's what you do with this. Let me put it up there so you can see. See how it's got the pulp in it there? And they give you a little toothbrush-like thing, and that's really the only part you have to clean. And I do remember with the other, well, in fact, she had two other juicers, and the basket that was in was really hard to clean. You had to just scrub and scrub to get the pulp out of it. Anyway, that's all you do, and you can actually put the little toothbrush down, and I call it a toothbrush because that's what it's like. You just scrub that little area there on the inside and the outside. And there it is, all clean. So now all I do is wash this in some soapy water, and but you can also put it in the dishwasher on the top rack. This is that little top section. And there's a little plunger, and that's really all there is to it. There's a lot of parts involved, but they're very, very easy to clean. All right, y'all, that's all I've got. All right, so I hope this is not way too long a video. We did drink every bit of the juice, every last bit of it. So that made 40 ounces. So pretty good. I still don't feel quite right. Let me back this up. With all the pulp going in the compost bin, I guess I'm really used to the Vitamix and having all the fiber and everything, but I think that this would be a really good, like if you're not feeling well, juicing like this would probably really, really help you. Like if you were sick with a cold, like what Mr. Bucky was talking about or something like that. And I know that the parsley, that Italian parsley, is loaded with potassium, which also makes you feel really good. And of course, we've got all the B vitamins. Anyway, I'm kind of getting excited about the juicing. We'll definitely be doing this one again. All right, we will see y'all next time.